everyone, and welcome to a new vlog. And today I'm gonna do a rehouse video. So I'm gonna rehouse my Gammastola Puga female and my Acanthus curia female as well. I'm gonna redecorate it and not rehouse, because they are going to stay in the same enclosure. And like this one, this enclosure I made myself, because you can see on the edges of the glass, it's not very straight, but it is from an old window. So I cut it myself and put it in together. So it's one I made myself also, like this one I also made myself. As you can see here the old, old clay or old silicone. It's not silicone, it's something else. But you can see it here, I can't wash it off. So, but it's not harmful for the tarantula. So I'm gonna rehouse these two. So let's do it. So I'm gonna start with my Gammastola Puga female. She is in, I guess in primo, because she's not eating for a while, and she has been eating a lot before. She's not an adult, maybe in 2 months. As you can see, this is very gentle and very slow, and as you can see, she's putting up her butt in the air. I'm gonna take out the water dish and I'm gonna try to catch her very carefully. So I have a trick for this. I only do this very simply. I put my lid from the container in it. I push her very a little bit back, so the lid is in it. Now I have this one. It's from a cricket box, where when you buy crickets. So I put it over her. As you can see, it's over her now. And then I gently, I hope you can see this, I gently move her to the lid. So she goes out on the lid. Do this very carefully. So now we have a tarantula in a box. So you can close it up. Just watch for the legs not be in between it. So yeah, here she is. So now I can start rehouse it. So it's empty. I removed the hide. So this is the hide, a rock sculpture. Like you see in the everywhere. So I'm gonna use the cocoa fiber that's in it, and I'm gonna make it with turf. In the early stages, when I started my tarantula collection, I simply used cocoa fiber, but now I'm starting to mix it, because it's better to mix with the turf, because it's a natural ground, and cocoa fiber is from a coconut. And sometimes, yeah, it's always loose. And when you mix it with turf, it's a solid. So yeah, for me, this is the best mixture for substrate, because turf and turf is like potting soil, but naturally. So turf and cocoa fiber is the best mixture, because turf keeps it solid, and cocoa fiber keeps it moist. So. Yeah, let's put the turf in it. So the turf is a little bit darker than cocoa fiber, but it's also fresh, so it's a little bit moist. I'm gonna mix it when everything is in. So let's mix it up and let's see how it gets. So now I'm gonna do it like this. Take every corner, mix and mix and mix. Okay, this is the mixture. So this is the ending now. So I'm gonna put back the hide. I'm gonna put the hide right here. So so she can dig in it. So that's the height. It's very simple because yeah, trenchlers don't need much. She sometimes digs, but it's always open. I'm gonna put the water dish right back. So that's the finished product. And now I'm gonna put her back in her enclosure. And let's see how she reacts. So hopefully she will enjoy it, but I guess she will without any doubt. So I hope. Okay. She doesn't like this plastic container. She really wants to get out of it. So. And there she goes. So yeah, I hope she likes this. No. Just simple design of her new enclosure. Not new, it's her old one, but I just put a little more substrate in it, so it will be cool. It's better mixture, it will be solider, it will be a lot nicer because the cocoa fiber before it was loose and everywhere because it was dry. And now there's turf mixed in it, so it will be a lot better. So yeah. So now I'm gonna rehouse my Acanthoscuria geniculata little female. She's not big, she's not an adult. I bought her like 8 months ago, maybe 10. But she was a very tiny sling. So at Acanthoscuria geniculata, fast growers, and luckily she was my second tarantula I bought. So the second one in my collection of more than 100 tarantulas, she is the second one, and I'm lucky that she turns out female. So I'm gonna rehouse her without any drama. So yeah, let's get started. I'm gonna do the same with this enclosure like I did with the Gramophila pulka enclosure, because it's also just cocoa fiber and I wanna mix it with the turf potting soil. So the substrate will be more solid and will be nice for the tarantula to move, because the water dish in the back that you can see here, that's the water dish. It was right in front of here in the corner. So she puts everything inside and yeah, it's always loose, it's not solid. So I guess she will be happy when I put the mixture in it. So yeah, same principle. I'm gonna use the lid, and for safety I'm gonna use my tongs, because she is hungry, because Acanthoscuria geniculata species are always hungry, like really hungry. So yeah, let's see what's happened. Okay, so she puts her butt in it, in the air, and as you can see, she's over there. So she's putting her butt in the air and kicking hairs. So now she's in the pot and I'm gonna remove her to the lid. Gonna click. She's kicking hairs all over. So yeah, here she is. That's my little female. She is little, she's not big, she's not an adult, but she turns out very beautiful. And she was like this big, guys, when I got her. So in 8-10 months you can get them to this. I power feed them when they are very tiny slings, but when they get bigger I feed them once a week, like this, once a week, maybe once every 2 weeks, but not And when it gets bigger, don't power feed them because I saw a video. Now it's back clean. And I'm gonna put it here in the corner. I'm gonna put some water in it. My Acanthoscura gymcorata female also back in her new home. So, or explaining just on the Instagram or on YouTube that when you power feed the tarantula, they have a lot of not healthy issues, but like if you power feed a male tarantula for breeding, it will turn out very little and not as big as it can be. So you have to be knowing what you do with power feeding. If you power feed the spiderling, yeah, it's understandable because you want to outgrow them, outgrow the spiderling phase, and you want to get them to the juvenile phase so they are stronger and not so fragile to die. So that's very understandable. But yeah, as you can see, this ground is very dry. I'm gonna put some in the bin, in the garbage bag, because yeah, as you can see, she had a water dish that she dug in. So I'm gonna clean this out. So everything is dry. Drier than this is not possible. It's very, very dried out. So the mixture with turf will be better because it will be solid. This is just loose. Just loose sand, and yeah, it's from a husk from a coconut. So it's a little bit dusty in here, sorry. So I'm gonna put the turf in it. The turf will also give another look, a more natural look, like how it would be in a forest. So I'm going to put a lot in it. It's always nice, and everyone always says put more substrate in it. You can never do harm with a little bit substrate. The more you put in it, the better. But yeah, still you have to see what tarantula do you have. Is it a terrestrial tarantula? Is it a boreal tarantula? Is it one that likes to dig? You have to adjust your enclosure. Is it likes to dig? Is it a tarantula that likes to dig like Ceriagopagopus species or the old Hoplopomus species? So if they like to dig like the old Hoplopomus species, then you have to change your enclosure and not buy like this one with a low, as you can see, low front lid. But you have to buy one where you can put a lot of substrate in it, so they can dig a lot, so they feel like home. And yeah, you have to adjust your enclosure for your tarantula as natural as possible, because yeah, it's their home, and when it's their home, you want them to feel happy in their place. Is it not good enough for them, they will show other signs like stress and everything else. But still, it's what you do. You buy your tarantula. When you buy a tarantula, you want to keep, you want to pet it, you want to make it happy. So this is how you do it. By the way, in the potting soil and turf, there are little wood in it, little pieces of wood. It's okay. This is my look for now. I'm gonna put it back a little bit higher than front, so I have a better look on it. So this is way better than before. I'm gonna put a highlight so she will be happy here. She probably will be, of course. So this is high, it's big, but yeah, she can go around it, and yeah, she will outgrow this enclosure, and yeah, it's temporary, you know, guys. Especially with species like the Acanthoscuria cinculata, they are very big species. They can get very big, they can get very large. So yeah. Of course, she's gonna be in another enclosure when she gets bigger. But for now, this will be it. And okay, that's what you see. What you see is what you get. Just like you say. And I'm gonna clean this water dish out. And when I'm done cleaning this, I'm gonna put some water in it. And yeah, put my cinculata female back in her enclosure, in her new enclosure. So yeah, be right back. Okay, that lid side is closed, it's off, so I'm gonna put her like this, and I'm trying, like this, everything is loose, she's kicking hairs, she's going out. Yeah, the hairs are floating everywhere, as you can see. So I'm gonna push her. Maybe I should delete. Push it right back. Yep. Just like that. So yeah, here she is in her new enclosure. I hope she will enjoy it after this stressful redecoration and capturing, because she didn't like it as much as I did. I'm going to take a picture for Instagram. So this was the rehouse video for today, and I hope you like it. If you have any questions, you can go on my Instagram and ask me what you want to know. If you want to know anything else, like what do I give him for feeding or anything else, you can check that out on my previous videos, or you can check them out on my feeding video. You can see what I feed. But if you have any other question for anything with what is tarantula related, or what I do, or anything else, just DM me or put your question down below. Until the next video, guys. Bye.